Hello everyone, this is B.B. Sangme, and in this today's video I am going to discuss about numerical of fluctuating stresses. Okay, do subscribe for the upcoming videos of machine design. So here we have the numerical. A component machined from a plate made up of steel 45C8. This is a plain carbon steel which is having the ultimate tensile strength 630 Newton per mm square. So here in this figure you can see the plate. Okay, it is subjected to a completely reversed axial force of 50 kN. That the plate is subjected to completely reversed axial force of 50 kN. The force is actually of a sign plus minus, because sometimes it is compressive, sometimes it is tensile in nature. The expected reliability is 90% and the factor of safety is 2. The size factor is 0.85. So here we have to determine the plate thickness, that is T, for infinite life, and here the notch sensitivity factor is 0.8. okay, so let us see what we have. The applied force P, which is plus minus 50 kN, ultimate tensile strength 630 Newton per mm square, factor of safety 2, reliability 90%. Okay, and here the notch sensitivity factor, that is Q, is 0.8 kb, that is the size factor, it is 0.85. okay, so first the step one is we are going to calculate the endurance limit stress for the plate, which is S dash E is equals to 0.5 SUT. Here the value of ultimate tensile strength is 630, so S dash E is 315 Newton per mm square as per the calculation. So from the figure we are going to calculate for the machined surface and for the given ultimate tensile strength, that is 630 Newton per mm square. So this is the figure. So for the strength of 630 Newton per mm square, I am going to draw a vertical line. I am going to calculate surface finish factor Ke. So let us draw a vertical line at 630 Newton per mm square. So this is the line, and here for the machined surface. Okay, so this is the curve of a machined and cold round surface. So at this intersection point, let me highlight this. Okay, so here somewhere at here I am getting at this line. Here you can see that the surface finish factor is near about 0.76. okay, next is the reliability. Okay, so in the problem the reliability is 90%. For the expected reliability, we are going to calculate the reliability factor, which is called as a KC. It is 0.897. okay, next is let us calculate the D by D ratio. So here capital D is 100 and small d is 50. Okay, actually it is the capital D is nothing but it is the width of the plate, maximum width of plate, and small d is the width of the smallest part of the plate, which is 50. Okay, so here the ratio is 2, and here you can see that there is a radius provided on the surface. Okay, so for this capital D by D, and the ratio is actually 2, so we are going to refer this curve. And for the R by D ratio, here we are going to calculate the stress concentration factor for the flat plate with the shoulder. So here you can see that the radius is 5R. okay, so total D is nothing but actually the width of the smallest part, R is the radius. Here you can see that the fillet radius is 5, so 5 divided by 50 is 0.1. so for the ratio of 0.1 and for the maximum to minimum width of plate ratio, that is 2, we are going to refer this curve. So for the ratio of R by D, that is 0.1, let us locate, let us calculate the value of KD. It will be something, let me show you here, somewhere at here we will get the value of KT. Okay, at this point, so this is near about, KT is 2.27. okay, because this point is 2.5, this 2.27. next is from the equation of KF is equals to 1 plus Q into KT minus 1, we are going to calculate the KF. We have the value of Q, that is Q is actually in the problem, it is given. It it is 0.8, which is the sensitivity factor, not sensitivity factor. Kt is already we have calculated 2.27. So let us put the value of Kt and Q in this equation. We will get the value of Kf. It is 2.016 as per the calculation. So let us calculate Kd. Kd is equals to 1 upon Kf, which is from the simplification. I have calculated 0.496. Next, let us calculate Se. The relation between Se and S dash is Se is equals to Ka into Kb into Kc into Kd into S dash E. We have the value of S dash E, which is already we have calculated, which is the endurance limit stress for the blood, okay, which is 315. We have the value of Ka, okay, it is 0.76. Kb is already given in the problem, okay, which is 2. Kc we have calculated, which is 0.897. Kd it is as per the calculation 0.496. okay, so let us calculate Se. Se is equals to 90.54 newton per mm square from the calculation. I have simplified it. I have put the value of Ka, Kb, Kc, Kd and S dash E, which we have calculated from the given data. So next is the step 2 is, let us calculate the permissible stress amplitude. So the formula is, for the permissible stress amplitude, SEA is equals to 0.AAC. okay, so already we have calculated SE. The value of SE is near about 90.54 newton per mm square. So let us put the value of SE in this equation. So SEA, that is permissible stress amplitude, is 72.43 newton per mm square as per the calculation. Next is, let us calculate sigma A, which is the ratio of SEA, that is permissible stress amplitude, divided by factor of safety. Already the value of factor of safety is 0.8, which is given in the problem. So let us calculate sigma A, stress amplitude. Sigma A is equals to 72.43, which is the value of SEA, that is permissible stress amplitude, divided by factor of safety is 2. Okay, so it is as per the calculation 36.22 newton per mm square. This is equation A. Step 3, that is last step, we are going to calculate the plate thickness, that is T. So here for this plate, the formula is induced stress amplitude, sigma A is equals to P divided by 50 into T. T is the thickness of plate. P is actually, it is the applied force, which is 50 kN. So for the applied load, I have written this equation in terms of T. We have the value of stress amplitude sigma A, it is 36.22. We have the value of P. Let us calculate the value of thickness of plate. It is as per the calculation. T is 27.61 mm. Okay. Thank you.